Okay, so as it stands right now, I've got a little bit of a problem where if I do anything, such as just resizing the window, it doesn't actually take. And then, okay, that's wrong, obviously. It's not negative time. It just like, but it's obviously still running in the background. It's just like not actually coming into within the next frame loop. It's just kind of skipping it all the time. Not great. Now, I think I've kind of narrowed it down to be the point where it's like, probably if it's one of these, actually, I'll bet. That it's probably like it's hitting this and then it's because. VK, okay. When I come through here, I reset the fences. If I do this, then it's not gonna hit through here again. I'm pretty sure it's because it goes into here, it comes out, and then VK wait for fences. This was already reset, but because we're coming back for it, actually. That may be a little bit of a thing. We can actually move this over. Actually, I think I just solved it just by coming online for a minute. Do this, right? If we reset the fences right here. Then it's going to be fixed. I'm going to bet you it's fixed. Yeah. Look at that. Now it's now it's fine. Okay, well, that was a bit of an easy fix, I suppose. May want to actually think about splitting it out anyways, because right now the per frame data is set up like this. We'll just actually change this to be more about ImGui. So there is this library called IMGUI, immediate mode GUI, which I wish to use as a temporary, or for the moment anyways, for UI. It implements all the basic stuff, and I really need some kind of in UI rather than relying on the text output. Now, I'm also going to have to actually deal with this stuff later as well. Mostly dealing with resizing and deleting objects a little too soon while it's still in use by command buffer, which I'll do later. Okay. It's obviously the first thing I need is to grab or bring in. I am GUI. Believe it's much like other things, it's a header-only library that really probably should be. I think it's header-only anyways. Include. Well, no, not that. Actually, no, we will need that. Source. Okay, usage. No, not really. Okay, let's grab this stuff down then. I'm just going to bring it down elsewhere. What do we got for tags? 1.79 looks to be the latest. Check out 1.79. Let's open that. We need this and this as headers. Let's copy that through. And then we need what looks to be widgets, internal, this, not that, 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 not the demo. We do need draw. Paste these in here. Okay. Minimum required. How is the? I'll just do like I'm going to just lowercase, whatever. This is going to probably require, no, don't do that. Just add the subdirectory of source. And in here we'll include files, sources. Okay. Just looking at the what's required for ImGui here. Okay. Let's do a little. I'm gonna ha I I really need to split up the graphics stack a little bit better. I'll do that after this. I'm gooey. Since this will be sitting basically right outside here. For ImGui renderer, actually. Yeah. Close that up, close that up, close that up, close that up. Maybe it's just like, no, just like faux. Just a, it's just a wrap around it, basically. Because I don't want it to actually be integrated into the regular graphics. It should be an optional thing, much like YAML. It's something you can have attached or not. Okay, we'll need. Is it lowercase? I am graphical user interface. No, that's already going to include what I need. Nope, 313. Plus everything else. Bring that in. Well, of course, in this case, I'm going to also require this stuff. So that's. That exports. We need this as well. We also need a directory source, which we'll also include. To make e lists. going to need a few items. We'll just get this. We'll get it to include its upper end. Like that. It's a class for the moment. I'll probably change it later for the moment for organizational purposes. We'll keep it like that. So this, okay. It's organized in frames. We're gonna, no, it'll have to be like that. Although it'll be a standard error code instead. For the moment, it can be this. While I figure this stuff out. Is that amazing? Okay, I'll figure out what else I'll need, but otherwise I'll need to deinitialize it as well later at some time, presumably. I need the ability to determine a new, I need to call into the ImGui new frame thing, so. And end a frame for it as well. Updating to draw. ImGui handles the draw command itself. Or rather, it gives us what we. Okay. Well, no, it's part of the draw command. All right, so it'll be at the end. So we just need the draw function. Command buffer. It's going to be drawn into. Need some resources for that. Okay. I know it can't be seen right now. I'm just looking on the other side of what I'm going to need. There's implementation files in there. Okay. I'll just have an overall function. The device, we need the VMA allocator. We need command pool, no, not command pool, descriptor pool. And descriptor set. this is doing a lot already. I need the render pass that this will be called from, and subpass as well. So that'll have to be passed in as well. At the very start. These are the things I do. The descriptor set is the font, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, it looks, it's going to be a start. So when we go into here, we need to include ImGui. Let's start with what we got. Okay, so we have destroy context. So just make sure this will have to be like a singleton that exists. I'm not going to enforce it. It'll just have to be, because it's only for use in development environments. And then we need to create the context when we first enter, of course. Don't even want to bother with this. Sure. Let's see what we got. Just copy and paste these guys in. It's basic style, looks like. Start with. Mentions. See, the thing is, I would actually use this implementation, but the problem is that it by default just sets the callbacks, it looks like. Oh no, you can actually don't have to. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. It's optional. Anyways, I want to pass it my own items. Anyways, where was I? These. I get the key mappings. Yeah, yeah. Which means we'll need to include that. A value for scale yet. Okay, just set 1.0f. Okay, is this even going to be compilable right now? Of course, I'm not even trying to compile it, so that's a bit of a problem right there. Graphics YAML. Okay, so it's after here. No source was given for that. Really? Yes, you'd be right, actually. Okay, I want to include that. This one, just stick with this one. We did build it, right? Yeah, there it is. So it builds fine for the moment. I need the allocator. Oh, no, I get it from this, right. Initialized function. Mm-hmm. which will be based on basically if this is not equal. And rather than this, it'll just call into these guys instead directly. Initialize. I'm not. I don't keep the device or the allocator. I don't need them, so I'll need to pass those guys through as well. Or just pass this in actually. Since he'll have everything, and he's like the public interface I'll have to work with. And then for each of the other failures, we'll come back. Okay. So, what we got going on down? Okay, get rid of the back of the GLFW. Go back to what is marmalade? Implementation metal. Apple. Vulcan. Ah, yes. I'm also going to require, when drawing, the sub. Frame index. The max frames. So we have to like have a number of descriptor sets. Maybe I'm not entirely sure actually, but I will need at least. Would I though? Am I the one keeping it? No, because I need to keep the vertex and index buffers. Looks like. Resizing the buffers, the viewports, and yeah, all this stuff. I want to integrate it as part of an already existing command. Basically, when I draw or finish drawing to the main window buffer surface, I'll tag this onto the end. Create fonts texture. I'm just like, again, I'm just I'm just scrolling through this file, trying to see exactly what I'm actually going to need.
Okay. So first of all, texture, font. Do I want to do okay, I'll do the yeah, I'll do the font stuff first. To font data. Okay. And then we need like that means we now have the size. Transfer. Here we go with the upload stuff again. Resource uploader. Graphics environment. With this, I'll I would do this. I need the command pool to need a temporary command pool so I can actually put this into video memory correctly. Then I need to wait and then I need to leave again. Okay. It keeps exploding in complexity as usual. Okay. Upload command pool. Just for use inside here. go. I mean, yeah, we're going to basically be using it for one thing only. Transfer source. Going back to this, we need. Okay, for the moment, I'll just say in32t. Transfer queue. Graphics. Queue. I'll hook those up later. So for the moment, it's. Transfer queue. I would actually need two of these, wouldn't I? Command pool on the source, one on the destination. Oof. Yeah, I would. Okay, whatever. If it failed, then it'll go down to this. It won't quite go down to this one directly, first of all. It'll have like a deinitialize. It'll deinitialize any local stuff. So if well, of course, I have to destroy that. That we want to do staging buffer. Okay, we were in the middle of the staging buffer, so VMA. Okay, I need to include VK memory allocation allocator. But only CPU use only to be copied up into the graphics. Like the what's in this, like a device memory, no, buffer and the allocation. Rather, staging buffer. Staging allocation. Okay, what exactly is preventing? There's a bunch of problems going on right now. Okay, cute. We got these guys. Okay, let's just update this. That's great. What's the next problem? IO. Oh, okay, I am GUI. Git IO to do dot fonts that blah 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 blah. Allocator, because it's actually from that. Got a create buffer issue. No matching function call. VMA create buffer. Oh, VMA create buffer. No, it does totally exist, guy. You just can't find it. Why can you not find it? No candidate. Oh, the candidate's not viable. No known version to second. Oh, address of rather than the value of this. Yep, I gotta change that up. Okay. ClangD's not out, is it? No, it's still around. Is it getting like IntelliSense trying to clashing with it? IntelliSense is disabled. Disabled. Okay. No idea. Like, yeah, it's probably hooked up. Whatever. It's compiling. It'll sort itself out in due time. Okay, we have this. And we gotta go to see if it is destroy buffer.
We have the state. Okay, at this point, we have the staging buffer. We want to map our data in. Yeah, font data to the destination. Just do data. Same thing as this again. If we could map it, just do that. Otherwise, we're doing a mem copy of destination from the source of upload size. Okay, that's a staging buffer and all that jazz. I need the image, and then I need the image transfer. Start with the image. Type. 2D. We'll just make it a constant. RGBA normals. Dot width equals. One sample, tiling is optimal. And usage, just copy this. Simple. Analog CI. Change it up to be VMA. Usage GPU only. The image. I don't really have that yet. But I would need it. So, first of all, okay, image view
font view, font image. And then, okay, sampler. Sampler and viewer first. Image and application are after. Same deal. If we fail, go to just jump. I've already got the data mapped in. Got the image, so I'll have to do the transfer. Script pool, yeah. Can I use the function I have from before? I don't think so. We can probably actually maneuver this around a little bit. Upload command pool. To the point where we actually need it there. Then I need the command buffer itself. For data and I'll move it out, yeah, like that. One times a bit is absolutely true. Need to have the buffer up here. Because when you destroy the pool, it just goes along with it. So we'll just do it that way. Doesn't really matter. Then we allocate the buffer. Pretty sure that this is going to require to go up to here, then we go out to here, and then we go out to here, and then we find that we need to give it the command pool. So oh wait, command buffer, allocate info. There are no flags here. Hold on. Oh, that's for the beginning. Yes, when we begin the buffer. primary. Okay, now that we've allocated it, perhaps, then we can begin it. One time submit, there we go, we got that, all nice. Okay, this should be of course it's a 3D type, not a 2D type. Resource loader, it's that, it's the graphics environment. I'm mentioning function for creating, are you sure? Okay. Now we're getting back into this again. Should be able to use that function more publicly, shouldn't I? Where is it? It's in here somewhere. It's like this thing. This. Then that intrinsically ties it to this. This may change. You know what? Just because this is special, I really should reuse it. I really should. It's a bit heavy-handed, but I'll reuse it. Resource uploader. We're going to create it here, right? Because I can create it just from a graphics type. So I don't actually need this extra resource command upload command pool. And this will also allow me to do the transfer between the transfer and the graphics queues much more effectively. Yes. Much like in here. So, okay, let's see how exactly I do it in here, and I'll just reuse it. The only thing I need is this. I need to have this, which will basically I can run on do on the fly. One. Do that and sub resource range. This is the VK buffer image copy area. One bit level, it's the color aspect, it's the offset of 0, and the extent equals image CI dot, oh, I don't have this anymore. This. We have staging. Buffer, we have the image, we have basically all the exact same stuff. Da 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 bam. Font image, actually. Upload data is not quite created at this point. I need it from earlier. Font extent equals whatever. Depth equals 1, and the others are 0 until we do font extent width. Oh, look, that's an integer type. Ooh, I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. This. Upload data is then created. Then we have go to initialization failed. Otherwise, we do this and go to submission failed. Submit failed is basically this, where we're always wait. We have to wait for it here, much like in this case. Yep. This can otherwise just skip it. And then we carry on and basically do the same thing, except for the image view in the sampler. So let's just do that. Copy these over. What do we need? That font image. Image type format equals VK format RGBA. One base level 0, that's also 0. We create the font view. Do the same thing for sampler. Is it nearest? Probably linear. Is it repeat? No, let's just do mode. Clamp to edge. And this will be linear as well. Even though, like, there's no mipmaps anyway, so whatever. And there's no anisope, any of that stuff. Hold on, let me just sampler. G font sampler, let's have a look at what they do. And they have this weird negative 1000, 1000 max, and yeah, okay. Linear, 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 repeat, repeat, okay. Address mode is repeat, repeat, repeat. Min LOD is negative 1000. Max LOD is 1000. Max anisope. It's false, so why would that? Why would one? Okay, whatever. Whatever. Create this. It's not create failed, it's initialization failed. Okay, I need to actually probably split this into a separate function first. Staging buffer and staging alloc are local to this as well. So it's command pool. This. And we'd also have to. Destroy the upload data. Regardless. Actually, these all need to be destroyed all the time, always. Not the pool, because we don't actually keep it anymore. It's not our pool. So where is it? Did I remove it already? I think I did. Okay.
creating a resource uploader. It's down here somewhere. Destroyed as well. Destroy the upload data. Same bloody order. Order, order. No, we actually probably want to do this so that way we can do all these resources and the descriptor sets and stuff and create the command pipeline pool while this is uploading. As odd as that is, that does actually make a bit of sense. But then I don't actually need all this stuff in that function. I just need these guys to be passed in and passed out. Later. Okay, static cast. Actually, I do, otherwise Microsoft will, compiler will go insane about that. Then I may as well just... What am I doing? Here, font extent equals this. Just leave this as uninitialized. Simple. Okay, the stuff I have, destroy it. So we'll go in reverse order. So yeah, I'm not going to be able to get this done in time. Okay, descriptor set will be destroyed by the pool. Do you want to destroy the layout? No, we want to destroy the pool, then the layout, because the set is the pool. using the layout. So, need to slightly rework that. There we go. Doesn't matter. Simple enough. And then we gotta do images, this stuff. Do-do-do-do. This also doesn't matter. This is the one that matters. If descriptor pool not equal that, if really it's just go down to the pipeline at the very end. You won't compile. Why? I'm sure there's a reason why. I need to change that to be a public type, I guess. I need this struct to be public. These are still handled internally. That's not actually. Not, yeah. It's a mixed bag. Okay, move this to public side. I didn't really want to move it to the public side, but I kind of need to for this. For the moment, at least.
Okay. Where is this function? It's in the private side of this. God. not doing great here. Although I'm going to have to figure out I'm going to have to rescope what's exported and what's not later, obviously. Rework exactly how I want these libraries to be done now. For the moment, though, getting things to work is what really matters. VK image buffer call P2. Oh, because that's taking in a vector right now. That's not good. I need to change that from a vector into this. Is count first or last second? I'm not sure. Okay. Like that. Copy region count. We change this over to that. Okay, we need to go to copy regions. It's the other way around. Let's count then the thing. Okay. Whoops, diddly doodly. That we gotta change this up to, instead of be like copy regions, pass the data in. Sampler review, then the image. Okay, this is probably just up here then.
Okay. So this at least presumably generates the image and stuff. I still need all this other stuff to do. Okay. Time to begin. Honestly, I probably should have put these into separate functions as well. This. Well, okay. Set layout. Set. Pipeline layout. Pipeline. Pool. Okay. Set layout. Set pipeline layout pipeline. Now we actually go down and start defining these wonderful little things. Out the initialization area, just kind of separate thing like that. Okay. Descriptor pool. We have what? Just the one descriptor. Right? For the one image, the font image. Yeah. Combined image sampler. One. Woo! Mind blowing. Got one set. One. Okay, we're creating one set layout, which is just the image on the fragment stage. Oh no, we do need a binding. Set layout binding.
this is where all this stuff actually goes in. How is it still undeclared? I've been in this first. Okay, you know what? Maybe I'll just restart. Yep. Okay, now it sees it all. They still need a bit of work on their little extension. Okay, what's this thing? Here. Oh yeah, because it's also going to require render pass and sub pass. Okay. We need the descriptor set. We need to just what? We allocate it. Oh, allocate. Set allocate info. Destination set equals info. Is it just descriptor set? I'm just declaring it that. Wait, no, that'd be. No, that'd be part of writing it. We just need the pool. Okay. Can I just see where I'm missing? Thank you. Descriptor pool equals end descriptor pool. Okay. I don't need to write it because I'm only writing it once. I don't need a separate function for that. I'll just do it in here. Actually, no. Maybe. Just return that. Keep it simple. So I do need like void. I need to move that back up. Okay. Whatever. Just do the whole thing. Otherwise, we carry on to write it. Okay. It's image. Hmm. reset. Got one. Got that. That should be that. The device, we got the one, and we got the one. I'm not doing any copies. Okay. Pipeline, I need to have a very basic, like an incredibly basic, let's have a look at the, what do they got? Do Falcon shaders. Okay, they already have like a couple of shaders basically ready for this. So basically just use these. There's no copyright or anything on this. But it's probably like under the copyright of, or license I should say, of this. It's MIT, yeah. So I'll copy them and put that license on it. Do. No, not that. You know what? Make it easy. Bam, job done. Copy that, paste it there. Then we got backends Vulkan. Vertex. This, copy that. Not modifying it at all. Notes and stuff are all taken care of. No one could say I didn't link back to this guy's stuff. For these guys. Now I want to put this into, what is it? Oh, yeah, okay, I'll update that. Why not? There's a way to just spit out plain old UN32.
Yeah, this.
User bin env sh.
Okay, four files in here. No, because there's only two files. And I don't want to do it for Markdown. So just validator. We want to convert into the UN32O. U32, I guess. Yeah, I guess. And do the same thing for frag. What am I even doing? Get out of here. CD libs, faux GUI. Do it. Magic. Yay. Okay. Just H. Ah, screw that, whatever. Whoops, I'm in the wrong one. Put it there. Do that. Yeah, that's fine. And then we'll replace that with the fragment stuff. Lost. There it is. Almost. Actually, just copy that in so that I know what version actually generated this. Okay, now we can include that was for pipeline. I didn't even need that for pipeline layout yet. What do I even need for pipeline layout? It's just push constants and scriptor sets. Push constant block. I need a push constant block. Okay, I need to include GLM for that. Okay, so that's the block I would need. Not the one we deserve. It's in the vertex section. Just never ends. So count. We got one layout. No errors, 395, really? Oh yeah,
return. Oh no, I could just return res again actually. It'll be VK success from up here. Pipeline, this is there's no shortcuts for this. This is just everything, isn't it? It looks like it. I don't think I can abstract any of that this away. No, it's just all kind of, well, it's not too bad actually. Like, I would just take a little quick gander. After the shader modules, of course, it's just. Wait, hold on. Oh, yeah, the attribute stuff to bring it in. No, it is basically everything, yeah. Okay. Oh, the creation of shader modules. I don't have that yet. Oh, boy. Okay. See if I can just kind of find for my pipeline pool. No, I can't because I split it up all the hell and back as well. Okay. Hold on.